Have you had your phone go off before during the?
We're right at this time, the week of the fight. Yeah, always people text and we got a lot of love, you know. Okay. Feel very special.
Yeah, well, obviously we spoke to you yesterday, but just a day close to the fight, what are the emotions like, you know, as you get closer and closer to getting into that cage?
This is the best part, man, you know, the best worst part, you know. It's almost done with the weight cut, you know. Today we start cutting the weight, and I mean, for me it's exciting, you know, because I know that, especially now the weigh-ins in the morning, I know that tomorrow by this time I'll be eating and getting ready for the fight. And you know, as of right now, I usually think like you keep going in scale, you don't even think about the fighting too much, you know.
What does your weight cut look like? How much are you cutting weight these days?
Right now it's kind of, it's nice, you know, it's nice. But I'm cutting like 15 pounds in a week. Yeah. Right now I'm like maybe 12, 13 pounds over.
Do you ever see a point in your career where you'll just think, I'll screw the weight cut and move up to heavyweight?
You know, I thought about it for a while. I was walking around way too heavy, you know, but I managed my diet off camp and feel much better in the light heavyweight division. I think it disciplined me more, you know. I get more discipline on the diet, on the focus on training, and you know, heavyweight, it's not something that I'm thinking right now, but hey, if the opportunity comes, it's a good opportunity, I'll jump in.
Anthony Rumble Johnson is coming back. He's coming back at heavyweight.
Yeah, he's big. He's big right now. I doubt that he can make it 205 again. He looks huge.
Your opponent Nikita has talked about how you guys actually have pretty similar MMA experience. I think you have 6 more fights than him. But you started competing professionally 10 years before he did. How does that time experience factor into the fight? Do you have are you the real veteran here?
Yeah, no doubt. You know. You know, Nikita, he's like, you know, this style of fight that he have, I like it. You know, he comes aggressive and he open up for a lot of things. You know, he open up for a lot of shots, a lot of punches, and those are the kind of guys that, you know, it's my kind of guy. You know, I just go over there and for sure that's what I do. You know, he'd have no decision. And in my career, I only have like, I think, 4 decisions, and I feel pretty excited about that.
I saw on your Twitter, you retweeted a stat by the UFC that you both have 4 submissions in the UFC. Is there any part of you that wants to get one ahead by tapping him out?
Yeah, no doubt. You know, I mean, submissions, and I think, yeah, the most finish, I think, tied with the Jon Jones right now for the record. So for the most finish in light heavyweight, you know. And I feel happy about that because a long time ago, Chuck was always telling me, hey, you wanna be popular, you wanna excite the fans, you want people to like you, go over there and finish fights. Because I think we just watch, I'm not gonna name it, and I'm not gonna say any name because it's long in the past, but like we watch a boring fight, you know. And I was like, oh my God, this fight is horrible, you know, the title fight is horrible, you know. And he's like, hey, man. You wanna be popular, you wanna make, you know, make money and get excited fans, go over there and finish fights. And now I'm like, you know, close to hold the record, the most finish in my weight class. And that feels pretty good.
You've mentioned Chuck quite a few times. And I remember when you made your way to the UFC among the more knowledgeable fans, an incredible record, you're an exciting fighter, but maybe not so popular stateside. How important has Chuck been to your UFC career?
You know, Chuck was the guy that I start with, you know. I start with, train with him. That's why I become professional. You know, I still look at him, the way he training, the way his head was, the way he confidence in the week of the fight. And all of that, you know, all of that was help because he's not a guy that talks, you know, sit down and talks a lot. I'm way, way more than that, you know. With my my students, I talk way too much, but Chuck is just don't say too much. But me, I was observing. I observed the way he react, the way he eat, the way he, you know, everything. So I learned a lot from him because at that time, you know, was the biggest name. The, you know, he was the biggest thing in UFC, him and John. And look at learning from those guys was great.
Glover, you're higher ranked than Nikita. What do you feel like you gained from beating him on Saturday?
You know, gain experience, gain, you know, beating him like in a good running for sure, like a knockout or submission is gonna, you know, get me in a third winning streak this year. Hopefully get to top five in the next fight, you know.
How much longer do you feel like you have to fight in your career? What other goals do you have left before you're done?
Man, you know, I love this fight stuff. You know, my gym is going well, you know. I don't have expensive lifestyle, you know. I'm very good doing it with my gym and the things that I do it outside. But like I'm fighting, I really love this thing. You know? I really love to be there, the excitement, and of course ups and downs. Nobody loves to lose, but every time you win, man, it's a rush. You know, it's amazing. It's amazing to be here this week. I enjoy this so. To be honest, I don't know how long more I'm fighting, and to my body's still going. I feel good about it, you know. But the day I still like, I'm not. I feel like go training. This is sucks, you know. This is that's the time I'm gonna. But I'm enjoying too much. I guess I'm gonna be one of the guys that my coach is gonna have to step in and start and tell me like, hey man, it's time to call out, you know, because I'm gonna keep fighting.
You mentioned you do have a couple of wins this year. I mean, what's been the key to success for you lately?
Discipline, you know, discipline, hard work, you know, but most of discipline, I was, I'm always a hard worker. I'm always in my career. I think I work harder than everybody. I'm like hard worker, but like I was doing like way too long of a camp and injuries a lot, you know, and in 2017, 2018, I have an issue with my shoulder and my hip, you know. So, but now I feel great. I feel great this year, coming in this year, you know.
You said yesterday you do like seeing the middleweight names come up to the division. Do you think any of them have a shot against Jon Jones, though?
Well, they gotta go through us first, right? I mean, they gotta go through us first, and if they beat us, you know, they jump in light heavyweight division. Like it's kind of like, hey man, this is our little thing over here, this is our ocean, you know. And they get a shot at Jon Jones, yeah, but they're not just gonna come in and fight Jon Jones, right? They gotta have to go through some of the top guys first, you know.
Glover, do you consider John to be the pound for pound best fighter in the world? Because it changes all the time. Some people saying Khabib now. You fought John, so you know firsthand how good he is. Who do you think is the pound for pound best?
You know, man, I think John is up there for sure. You know, John's like after I saw Khabib last fight and Dustin Poirier, I saw that kid training. I saw how good he is, and the way he dominated Dustin Poirier is like. In my mind is like, you know, he's definitely the number one pound for pound. This is the way Jon Jones win more title defense and all of that, but Jon Jones haven't dominate opponents the way Khabib has been, you know. Khabib is just like he look like he have like way too much, you know what I mean? He's way above the guy. He's like the 10 and all the people that fight him is 7.
Thank you, guys.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate it.